By the way, I'm probably getting a new desk soon, so that'll be exciting. Because the desk right here, it's actually like a hallway table that I just drag in here. So a desk that's already in here and set up will be nice. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Just JP. I'm Justin, and today I am doing a viewer request. This is from Jim Bricker. Jim, seriously, thank you so much for always watching, always commenting, always joining me here, and joining me on JPNP on the other channel. It's much appreciated. Seriously, really. So, Frank Zappa Montana. Frank Zappa is a name that I've heard of, but I really don't know much about him. I believe that he's kind of experimental in his music, but honestly, I cannot say that I've ever heard a song from him. Frank Vincent Zappa was an American Let me try that again. Was an American multi-instrumentalist, musician, composer, and band leader. His work is characterized by non-conformity, free-form improvisation, sound experiments, musical virtuosity, and satire of American culture. Okay, so one word, experimental, maybe a little unique. I honestly have no idea like what this is going to be like. Jim, I hope you haven't given me some like super weird song. We're gonna find out though. Join me on Twitter. Please join me in the comments below for discussion and let me know what you thought of the song yourself. Share the video if you enjoy it. Like it if you do. Subscribe if you want to see more and if you want to stick with me for future videos and music. And of course, let's get into it. This is Frank Zappa with the song Montana. Oh,
gonna buy me a horse just about this big and ride him all along the borderline with a pair of heavy-duty zircon encrusted tweezers in my hand. Every other wrangler would say I was mighty grand. By myself, I wouldn't have no boss, but I'd be raising my lonely dental floss. Well, I might ride along the bottom with my tweezers gleaming in the moonlight at night. And then I get a cup of coffee and give my foot a push. Just me and the pygmy pony over by the dental floss. And then I might just jump back on and ride like a cowboy into the dawn of Montana.
Jim.
Excuse
me. I was talking. Give me a second, because there's a little bit to dissect here. So just give me 1 second. Okay. So I really quickly went to Wikipedia because I just wanted to know what exactly Frank Zappa was like playing in this song, so that way I could kind of talk about that a little more. So it seems that he was not only the voice, but also the guitarist. So I just wanted to have that little bit of knowledge so I knew what he was doing within the song. I didn't know what he specifically played in there. But it did say that he composed it, so it's his song. Makes sense. Man, I'm really kind of like, I'm not exactly sure what to say. Instrumentally, all right, so let's just break it down a little bit so I can kind of figure out my thoughts and talk it through with you guys. Instrumentally, it was really good. The drum and the bass, solid foundation, very groovy, and I don't use that word because it's 2019 very much, but it's super groovy, and it came out in 1973. I do like the guitar, especially the solo. The solo was really good, and I like the playing he does, especially near the end of his solo, because it's a little, it's not like a straightforward, it's a little like this whole section right here. Let me lower just a little bit. This whole section right there is really good. I like the soloing, I like the guitar tone especially, and that would be really fun to see live. And I actually really like how it opens up. It actually took me a second. I actually really like the way that the song opens. Even going into his pretty much just speaking vocals, I actually really like it. It begins just right on top of it, everything's going full speed, then it just brings it all back after that amazing drum fill and goes right into that smooth pace of the song. And I actually like his vocals in the speaking part. It took me off guard. I will admit that. And I'm sure most people, the first time they've heard this song, it's probably taken them off guard because I wasn't expecting it. But the tone of his voice, and he has this deep, smooth voice that's almost a little like, he's very self-aware. Like he knows he's just like, you know, smoothly talking over these beats and over the song and everything. He's just doing his thing. So I like that. I like the confidence of it. When he started getting a little sillier in his delivery, I can't say I was a huge fan of that, but I get it and I could understand it. I think the background vocals were very interesting. And from what I read back here, it says that it features backing vocals by Tina Turner and the Iquettes. And I thought it was very interesting what they did with that in the second part of that fast, like, little break with them. Let me see if I can find it really quick. So, like, that whole part where it's like the piano mixed with like their harmonies and their vocals, I think it's very interesting. I think it's very interesting the way they did that, because on the first part of that, they are just normally singing from what it sounds like. And I don't have video or anything like that, so I'm just going off of what I'm hearing. They're singing normally, they're harmonizing normally, but when it gets into this part, it could very well be that they are singing it at every single time that note is pressed on the piano, that they're singing that note. It could very well be that. But it sounds more like their voices were sampled and they were played on the keyboard or on the piano. And that's what makes that kind of layered sound between the actual piano note and their harmonized voices, especially when they're more pitched up and more, what's the word? Edited, basically. So I think it was very interesting the way they did that. And sound-wise, it did sound good. It sounded a little weird, but that's obviously the tone he's going for. And it actually works as a whole. Now, I don't know much about Frank Zappa. For all I know, this could be his most experimental song. For all I know, this could be his most straightforward song. For all I know, it could be somewhere in the middle. But it does give me a good introduction into what I could probably expect from him. Even though I know he's done so much music, I'm sure it spans so many different sounds that I probably wouldn't know exactly what to expect from him. The lyrics. I don't know. I might be moving to Montana soon just to raise me up a cup. Crop of dental floss, raising it up, waxing it down. In a little white box that I can sell uptown. By myself, I wouldn't have no boss, but I'd be raising my lonely dental floss. Raising my lonely dental floss. I don't know, dude. But here's the thing. I like to try and figure out lyrics sometimes, okay? Now, I do like the second verse where he says, well, I might just grow some bees, but I'd leave the sweet stuff to somebody else. And then on the other hand, I would keep the wax melted down, pluck some floss, and swish around, blah, 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 blah. I don't even know that part. Where he says he might grow some bees, but he'd love the sweet stuff, the honey, the leftovers, the product, to someone else. Almost like, this is what I kind of take it as, and I know this is going to be kind of off. I'm sure it's not what he intended. It sounds like it's his way of talking about his music. He'll grow his bees. He'll do his thing. Because bees, although they're cool, like they are super cool, I love bees. Like, you couldn't pet a bee. You couldn't like interact with a bee because you'll get stung. It's a little, you know, his music is maybe not as straightforward and sweet as other music, especially in pop and most mainstream music. So he says, but I'd leave the sweet stuff to somebody else. He'll leave that kind of music to someone else. He's going to do his thing, which may be a little prickly, but it's still cool. And I really don't know. So would I listen to this song? No. I wouldn't listen to this song, but I have a feeling you probably already knew that. I honestly, I am super interested to hear more from him based on what I've heard, but this song, while it's a great introduction and it is good in its own right, it's just nothing that it's not something that I would personally like listen to. What his vocals did remind me of because of his speaking was Cake. For example, the song The Distance. Starting one after with the cop buddies. I'm muscle for rank. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern as they speak. Now his is a little more like on point. Frank Zappa's was a little more, there's a word. Now even when I first heard Cake, it actually took me a while to get into his vocals because obviously I'm very used to singing in vocals, not like this speaking, half singing kind of thing. Now, Frank Zappa, he was pretty much for the most part straight speaking, even though there were parts where he kind of sang a little bit in his voice, or at least gave it a little more of a melodic tone. So maybe it's really just a case of me having to get used to his vocal style. Maybe he doesn't always do that. I really have no, because this is the first song I've actually heard from Frank Zappa. So even though it wouldn't make my list, I'm still super curious, actually very curious, to hear more from him. Of course, let me know your thoughts on the song, maybe why you enjoy it, maybe what other songs you enjoy from him, or in this kind of realm. Join me on Twitter, join me in the comments below to discuss, and share the video, like it if you enjoyed it, and I really do hope that you did. Thank you for watching, Just JP. I'm out of here.